Okay, go. Wow. The motor is actually running. Hi guys, this what you see is a 220 volts, 1000 watts DC motor. Now, DC supply of 220 volts is not usually available, so we make a boost converter to operate it at 12 volts DC supply using a battery. Now guys, if you are an old subscriber of mine, you might be familiar with this switching circuit which I constructed a few months back. But if you are new, you can find the construction link in the description of this very video. So guys, without any further delay, I'm going to use this UPS transformer. This is the blue and white wire which represents the high voltage side. You can see the wires are thin because the output voltage is going to be high but the current is going to be less. So this side is going to be on the other side, keeping it like this. And these wires are really thick, means they are going to draw huge current, making it the low voltage high current side. These two red wires that you see, I've already showed you in my previous video, these will be connected to the black wires. And this red wire is the tapping point to which the 12 volts DC input supply will be connected. And this black wire that you see to this wire, negative supply from a battery or a DC power source will be connected. Now strip it. Now guys, here as you can see that I have a bridge rectifier that converts AC supply to DC supply. Vanco KBPC3510. Capability of up to 35 amperes, and this terminal is AC and this is DC positive. So AC represents the blue wires, these two, which will be connected to the output terminals, the high voltage side of the transformer, to which I'm going to do the connection. Okay, and the other one as well. Now guys, just for safety, I'm going to use this large DC capacitor, 1400 microfarad with a voltage of up to 450 volts DC. So we have to make sure that the polarity is same. This orange wire that you see, this indicates positive from the rectifier. So positive will be connected to the positive. Okay, positive has been connected. Now comes the negative. So guys, this is the 12 volt 7H battery that I usually use. Okay, let's keep it on this side. This terminal is luckily positive, so it's connected over here, and this is negative, which will be connected over here. So guys, here I'm going to use the same old cheap multimeter, and let's point it towards 1000 volts DC. The other multimeter of mine is really expensive, and I still don't know how much the output voltage is going to be and what is going to be the frequency. And it also has a stand, so it is more useful that way. Although I think I will have to use this piece. Make it visible. Yeah, now it is. Let's turn it on and see how much output DC volts I'm getting. This is the final negative terminal that will be connected to this 12 volts battery. Okay, so keep watching the display screen. Whoa, the output voltage is really high as 400 volts. How is that possible? Maybe it's the open circuit voltage because of which the voltage is so high, but when I connect an actual load, the output voltage is going to reduce. So with that hope, let's connect the DC motor directly to the output terminals of the capacitor. Now guys, here we have the DC motor running pretty good. Now here comes the terminal connection for it. Let's connect this wire to this one. Done. Now the second one. Okay, yeah. So both the wires have been connected. Okay, go. Wow. The motor is actually running. And the speed is also fine. Okay, here I've connected my DC clamp meter with a capability of up to 600 amperes measuring current. Okay, so guys, keep watching the display screen. Okay. You can see that the current is as high as 7 amps and it is continuously increasing. Oh. Around 9 amperes it is drawing, which is a lot for a 12 volts battery.